What's going on, guys? It's your boy Scrub here, back again with another video. Hope you guys are having a great day. I know I am. Today, I've got a pretty crazy story time for you guys about the time I witnessed some dude lose like 600 grand in 20 minutes. Me and a couple of my friends ended up in this very bizarre situation. Regardless, I'm sure that's got y'all intrigued, so I won't dilly-dally no more. Be sure to press the like button if you're hyped for the story. It helps out a lot. And without further ado, let's get into some dude losing a crap ton of money more than I've ever seen in my entire life in a couple minutes. Cause damn, you know that one had to hurt. Let's go. Alright guys, so I say this pretty often, but for those of y'all that don't know, I actually live in Las Vegas, Sin City, and gambling is our major industry. You know, it honestly is what the city is like centered around. Our only major skyscrapers, our only big buildings are like casinos or casino related, like a resort or something. And I know to a lot of people that's pretty weird. It's not bizarre to me to be like surrounded by casinos and gambling whatnot, because I was born and raised here, so I'm just used to it. However, my roommate who lives with me definitely is not from Las Vegas, so he thought it was like the coolest thing ever. My roommate Bake, I'm probably gonna call him Zach for the rest of the video, because that's what I know him as, not as his internet name. Had never ever been to the Strip, which is where all the casinos are in Las Vegas. And he was like, listen, man, you know, I really want to go. I just want to see what it's like. I've never seen a casino. And when I say casinos are commonplace in Las Vegas, like every time I go to a movie theater, I would walk through a casino. Our grocery stores are in parking lots with casinos in them sometimes, like little gambling cafes, bro. It isn't bizarre, but I guess to everyone else, it's crazy. And he really wanted to go, and I told him the truth, which is if you're not 21, it isn't a very good time. The only really fun things to do down on the Strip are like party and gamble and whatnot, and you have to be 21 to do all that. But the amount of crazy people down there does mean that, like, people watching is a pretty good time, and you know, there wasn't really much else to do. I wasn't 21 at the time. This is like close to 2 years ago now. Wow. Anyways, my friend was like, yo, dude, I really want to go see it. So we decided to just go down to the Strip one night and do some people watching in Vegas. So we get there and we're kind of walking around aimlessly, having ourselves some fun. We saw some pretty interesting things early in the night, dude. I literally saw one guy. I'm not sure what he was on. All I know is I want some of it. And he was like fighting a tree. And when I say fighting a tree, I'm not talking about arguing with the tree. I mean, he was doing that, but along with shouting at the tree and it wasn't replying, he was literally like punching the tree, which could not have felt very good on his hand. That was interesting to see. We're wandering, just doing our thing. And finally, we make our way into like one of these casinos. And the way the casinos on the Strip are outlined, like the entire bottom floor of this giant building is basically a huge casino. And it was me, my friend Zach, and then another friend of mine who wasn't from Las Vegas. And they were like really fascinated with the gambling. Obviously, we couldn't play it because we're not 21, but they just kind of wanted to stand there and just absorb the atmosphere, like watch people gamble. And while, you know, I'm used to it, I understood it wasn't something they'd seen before. So we were just kind of sitting there drinking some soda, obviously soda. And we were just kind of watching the hotel do what it does, the casino do what it does. And as we're just kind of standing there getting hyped when somebody would win a lot of money or something, these like group of dads comes up to us and they're just kind of talking to us. They're like, yeah, we saw you guys, you guys are our son's age. And we were like, oh, how funny, they're probably doing a guy's trip in Vegas. And we're kind of like, oh yeah, sure, whatever, just being nice to these dudes because we're bored. It's not like we had anything to do, and like they seem like a bunch of dads just trying to, you know, have some fun in Vegas. Not that type of fun, okay, just to be clear, but like, you know, oh look at those kids are our son's age, I bet you they go to college. Like, I don't know, dads are weird, because you know, I don't play on that side of the team. As flattering as it is, I wasn't trying to have a great time in Vegas with these dudes. And they started asking us questions about Vegas, you know, and my friends weren't from there, and they're like, oh, have you guys ever gambled? And we say no, obviously, because legally we can't, we weren't old enough. And the guy is like, well, have you ever da-da-da? And I couldn't hear him, and I asked him to repeat it, and he kind of looks at me and he's like, well, have you ever seen high roller gambling? And to be honest with you, I've lived in Vegas my entire life and I've never seen high roller gambling. I've heard rumors about it, like people literally blowing hundreds of thousands of dollars and millions of dollars in a night. I know they exist, I've never seen one, but they have high roller rooms in some casinos where like you have to be gambling a certain amount to even be worth playing there. Like, you know, yes, I'd heard of rumors of it, but I'd never seen anything like it. No, because I'm not a high roller. I'm not out here throwing hundreds of thousands of dollars down on the poker tables. And he's like, well, look, we're gonna go gamble a bunch of money. You know, this is a gambling trip. If y'all wanna just watch people gamble with a lot of money, like you can just hang out with us, you know, and just kind of like have a good time. And obviously there wasn't really much else for us to do, and we were like, sure. So we go to get some food or something. I think we went to like a buffet and we were just kind of talking, and they're telling us that they do a yearly gambling trip. Like this is the yearly trip where they all come to Vegas and have a good time, and their wives love letting them do it because like they make a bunch of money when they're here off gambling. And obviously at that point, curiosity got the best of me, and I was like, okay, you don't have to answer this question, you know, if this is too personal, you can tell me, I won't take it the wrong way. How much money do you guys make on a trip? Like, you guys do this trip every year, you're saying you're professional gamblers, you're high rollers, like, how much money do you guys actually make while you're doing this stuff? And the guy looks at me, he's like, well, do you want the honest answer, like a no BS answer? And I'm like, well, yeah, obviously. And he's like, well, it's a lot, and that's why the wives are so supportive of it, da 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 da, and he's like really hyping up this number, and I'm not gonna lie, it was kind of annoying. I'm like, dude, just tell me. And he finally says the number, and my jaw literally drops. He says that they were making like $2 to $3 million each trip that they were taking out to Vegas. $2 to $3 million in a single trip? Hello? How? You might as well just tell me that you have a yacht and a jet and 80 servants that's job it is to wash your feet. Like, it's genuinely mind-blowing to me that some people can just gamble millions of dollars. Like, oh yes, you know how it is. I went on vacation with the boys, came back $3 million richer. Seems like a pretty nice life, I can't even lie. Like, yeah, odds are this dude's dad probably robbed someone at some point and now handed down a bunch of whatever. I have no clue. I have no idea what this guy's life story is. Regardless, he's making $2 million a week while partying in Vegas, which, you know, sounds pretty sweet. And at that point, the guy gets up from the restaurant and walks out, and I'm like, oh, well, don't we have to pay? And he's like, no, it's complimentary for me on the hotel. And they all get up and just walk out, and the waitress, like, nods and tells them to have a great day. So we're like, huh? These dudes just told us they're making $2 or $3 million a week, they're not buying things at restaurants, and they're allowed to leave. Like, what is going on, dude? Obviously, we're just fascinated at this point. So all the dudes are, like, walking out of the restaurant, we're following them, and we ask where we're going, and they're like, all right, well, we're gonna go gamble, and you guys are more than welcome to come watch us if you want. And obviously, like I said, there isn't a ton of stuff to do when you're 21 on the strip, and considering these guys are, like, apparently about to go gamble millions of dollars, yeah, that seems pretty entertaining, dude. Like, watching somebody deal with that much money, I don't know what it is, but just the pressure of it, the intensity of it is sick. And it's not my money, so if they lose, like, yeah, that sucks. It's like a real-life Mr. Beast video with raining money. The only difference is it's like gambling instead of just giving it to people in need. And on the way to, like, the casinos after the buffet, I'm kind of asking him, like, oh, what games do you play? Because I don't know a metric crap ton about gambling. I probably know more than, like, the average American, just because I live in a gambling city. But I was expecting them to say poker or, like, something involving some strategy, because usually if people are consistently winning at gambling, like, it has to be a game that has some thought to it. You know, something where, like, it's repeating results over and over again. And they tell us that, like, their favorite game to play is roulette, which is pure luck. Like, okay, I'm sure somebody out there is going to make an argument, well, technically, if you read a book and da-da-da-da-da-da-da, like, roulette is basically pure luck. Roulette is a lot more luck than poker or something that I was expecting them to say. So I'm not an expert, but obviously I was a little bit like, huh, you guys consistently make money on a game that requires no skill? It's just the ball spinning around the roulette wheel. It's not like there's a button you press or anything like that. And so I just kind of ask them how that works, considering roulette isn't a skill game. And I'll never forget the look that they gave me when I asked that, dude. You would have thought that I just asked them if I could have their wife later. Like, they actually act like I had just insulted their soul. And the main guy who had been flexing to us the whole time is kind of like, oh, trust me, dude, I have tons of skill. Like, don't even insinuate that. Trust me, I'll show you. Like, trust me, I have a plan. It works every time. And personally, I don't really believe the dude. Like, it just seems weird to me, but he seems really pissed off that I even had the nerve to insinuate that he might not have the code crack to winning at roulette every time. Call me crazy, but I feel like if you really had a working roulette strategy, you would be making a lot more than $2 to $3 million a week. I know a lot of you guys are like, what? That's still so much money. But yeah, this guy is apparently saying that he can win at gambling anytime, guys. You do realize that, like, casinos in Las Vegas are doing billions. If this guy can literally win every time, why is he, like, not a billionaire at this point? So, whatever, they seem annoyed, and, like, Zach tapped me on the shoulder, told me to chill out, so I decided to relax a little bit, and we start walking over to these roulette tables. And when we get over there, they walk up, and me and my friends had to stand, like, a few feet back from it, because we weren't 21. We obviously weren't allowed to, like, be at the table or play or anything, but we were just kind of watching, and we were still close enough that we could see everything going on and hear everything going on. Like, it wasn't a situation where we weren't present, you know, they could still talk to us. They had to turn around a little bit, but we could see what was going on in the game, and the roulette wheel is just kind of sitting there. Obviously, it's, like, one of the most iconic gambling games, you know, the, oh no, it's gonna land on red 32, like, it's one of the most iconic gambling games. And they walk up to the table, and we're just kind of watching it, and I look over, and I see Zach and my other friend's eyes kind of wide, because they're like, oh, we're about to watch gambling, you know, and I don't know why they thought it was so cool. Anyways, the ringleader dude steps up all cocky, and he's like, $5,000 on green. And some of you probably know what that is, I'm gonna guess some of you don't, so I'm just gonna break it down really quick, just to let you know how stupid that was. So, roulette basically works in a way where if you're wrong, like, you lose all the money you just bet. So, unless this guy somehow manages to get this to land on green, he's about to lose $5,000 in one roll of their roulette, right? And the odds of it landing on green are 35 to 1, so a 1 in 35 chance of it landing on green, not very good odds. To break that to a percent, just so y'all can, like, understand how stupid that is, literally just under 3%, and it's a situation where, yeah, if you win, you 35x your money, so you make 175 grand. But there's a reason the saying is the house always wins. You know what I mean? Casinos are able to operate and make profit because they're really, really good at making sure that you leave with less money than you came with, you know? So, unsurprisingly, it rolls and it doesn't land on green. I'm not shocked. It is like a 3% chance. And he, like, slams his fist on the desk and is like, oh, it should have gone green. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm pretty sure that's not how roulette works. You have no way of knowing what it should land on. It's completely random. But he's, like, swearing, saying that this table is rigged, all this stuff, all pissed. And he's blaming the table, but then doubles down and puts another $5,000 on green. And the wheel spins again and he loses it. And he's like, oh, what the hell? Dude, this table is rigged. So I've watched him piss away 10 grand at this point pretty quick. Like, minutes have gone by. He's down 10 grand. And he's starting to get mad. And I'm not a gambler by any means. I've stayed away from it just because I've got an addictive personality and I'm not trying to blow all my YouTube money at the casino. But one thing that I've always heard from everybody who gambles is that you should never bet angry. What happens when you're mad? You start to get irrational. You start to get stupid. You start doing things you wouldn't normally do. And so the advice is never gamble mad. Well, this guy is getting pissed that he's losing and he just keeps putting $5,000 on green over and over and over and over and over again. I think in his head, he thought like a bet eventually it had to land on green, which isn't really how probability works. Like, it's a 3% chance every time. Just because you're repeatedly doing it doesn't mean the chances go up every time. So he just keeps putting the money down, and he ends up losing 5 bets in a row, so he's down like $25,000 in a couple minutes. And me and my friends are just standing there with our mouths gaping open, because like, I had never seen anybody just toss around money like it was so worthless before. This dude was really just throwing around $25,000 like it was play money, the way I would gamble with like Monopoly bands, and he was literally throwing around a down payment on a house like it was nothing. But when he turns around to see what's going on, he sees me and my friends kind of standing there with our mouth open, and I don't know if he was like embarrassed or what, but what he decided to do next definitely didn't make him seem smarter. He starts swearing that he's gonna win his money back, and just watch, trust me, I'll win it back. And we start telling him like, bro, you don't have to do that, it's okay. And he turns back around, and I'm like, dude, I hope he slows down, because that's another thing they literally tell you not to do when you gamble, is like, never swear you're gonna win back money that you've lost. They say you should only gamble money that you're willing to lose. But when he turns back around, he goes $25,000 on green. His plan was like, oh well, if it goes green now, it'll give me 35 times $25,000, so I'll make money. And sure enough, dude, it doesn't land on green. Who would have thought? And the guy is sitting here pissed like, surprise Pikachu, the strategy hasn't worked once for you, and you just keep doing it. That's not the best move. And when he loses the $25,000, he doesn't get mad, he doesn't even say anything, he literally is just silent. He doesn't talk to his friends, he doesn't turn around, he's just grimacing and looking like he's questioning his life, which honestly I would too. Like, how could you not? He's literally down 50 grand in a couple minutes, and it looks like he's just kind of sitting there trying to think about how he's going to explain this to his wife. But instead of deciding at that point to relax or like calm down, he goes 50,000 on green, and he says it with confidence, almost like he thought he was in a movie, you know, like it was a James Bond movie, and if he just said it with enough confidence, the dealer would like press the button and let him win. So he loses the 50 grand, so now he's down 100-something thousand dollars, and the entire table is silent. None of his fans, like, friends are laughing, the dealer's not laughing, we're not laughing. Like, these guys were in a great mood before we sat down, and now this guy looks pissed. And I don't blame him for being pissed, I really don't. And I think at this point we all expected him to stop. Like, there's no way he's gonna keep going. He really just gambled away a mortgage, like $600,000 eventually, but at this point he's at $100,000. $100,000 is a house in a lot of parts of the country, you know what I mean? Like, he was literally gambling a house. He probably was pissed, yeah. So at this point the guy's just desperate, bro. He's just chasing a win of any type, and he puts $100,000 on red to try to win something, which at that point half the roulette is black, half is red. I mean, there is like two green circle thingies, I don't know what to call them. So it's basically a coin flip, dude. This guy is doing a $100,000 50-50 situation, and it's intense to watch, bro. That's a lot of money on the line. And sure enough, this guy takes a ginormous L. Like, he must have punched a nun that day. That's the only way to be this unlucky. But apparently this guy hadn't had enough yet, because as soon as that one goes down, he's like, well, I want to put $100,000 on black. Like, he's just chasing his winnings so bad, it's hard to watch. But his friends aren't stopping him, and I don't know this dude, I've never been in a situation like this before. It's just hard to watch. Like, we're like, what is going on? He's just being really irrational, and sure enough, dude, he loses another 100 grand, because it goes on red. Like, it was basically just doing the opposite of whatever he wanted it to do. And the guy at this point still hasn't had enough, bro. He still decides to go be more of a moron. Another $100,000, but this time he's like, oh, okay, so $100,000 on red didn't work, $100,000 on black didn't work, let's put it on green. Even lower odds. Like, really, it's even lower odds. This guy was just trying to be broke, maybe, I'm not too sure. But when he loses this time, I see a single tear, like, rolling down his cheek, dude. And I'm like, all right, well, now he's crying. I've just witnessed him lose all this money. There's no way he's gonna keep going. Well, you would think so, but sadly, sometimes people's brains apparently just shut off when they're gambling, because he does it again, bro. He does it again, for good measure. I've never seen someone as unlucky as this dude, and me and my friends are literally just standing behind this table, like, mouths gaping open, not knowing what to do. We really had just watched this guy lose, like, $600,000 in 20 minutes, maybe, in front of our eyes, but the guy still isn't done. He just lowers the amount. I think he lowered it back down to, like, 5,000, keeps going, finally hits something, wins some money or whatever, nowhere near as much as he lost, and he gets up, dude, and I've never seen someone look more defeated. Like, this guy honestly looked like he had just been punched in the face by Mike Tyson. Like, he just found out that his daughter has a Belle Delphine fan page, and he kind of like starts walking over to us, and when he turns around, the defeated look kind of turns into a grimace, and he's like kind of storming over to us, and he gets over and he's like, did you guys just see me lose all that money? I lost, you know, over $500,000 over there. Did you guys see that? And we're like, yeah, dude, I know, I'm super sorry. Like, that looked like it sucked, because hey, I've never lost $500,000 in a night. I don't have $500,000 to lose, but I'm gonna guess that it really sucks, you know. Hey, call me crazy, I know, Scrubby with the crazy hot takes. Losing hundreds of thousands of dollars in a single night probably does not feel good. Alright guys, I'm gonna interrupt the video for just 1 second. On screen now is actually a PlayStation gift card. I give one of these away every single day here on the channel as a way to just say thank you to all of you guys for being subscribed with notifications on and supporting the channel. So yeah, if you wouldn't mind taking a second to subscribe, turn on notifications, it does help out a lot, and I literally give away free money, so you got nothing to lose. On that note, I'll shut up so you guys can get back to the story time. Thank you very much, and have a good one. And at that point, he's like, well, it's all your fault that I lost that many times. And obviously, we have no clue what this dude is talking about. And he starts saying that, like, we're bad luck charms, and we were probably sent to the hotel to, like, make him lose and get in his head. head and, you know, what type of voodoo we did to him to mess up his luck. And obviously none of us know anything about voodoo. I don't think I look like the type of guy who would know anything about voodoo. So we start laughing, thinking that this guy is kidding. Like, obviously it's not our fault that you bet on green 12 times in a row. But when we start laughing, he doesn't start laughing. He gives us a look as if, like, he's very serious, dude. And at that point, we're like, oh, this guy's not kidding. He's unironically trying to blame us for him being just an absolute moron. And that's when he says something that y'all won't believe whatsoever. He starts saying that because we're bad luck charms and it's like our fault that he's lost all this money, we have to help him get his money back. Like, we have to give him money so he can go gamble and win it back. And listen, dude, YouTube pays me pretty well, but I really do not have an extra $600,000 laying around to give to this no-brain. And even then, you want me to give you money to go gamble when I just watched you lose $600,000? Yeah, no. So we tell this dude, like, look, I'm sorry you lost a bunch of money, but that's on you. We're not gonna help you. Like, just, it was tough love, but I don't know this dude at all. And he seriously thought that we had, like, put a curse on him, man. We were not gonna help him give him his money back. We weren't gonna give him any money. Like, it wasn't our fault that he had gambled it away. And even then, you didn't lose it to me. You lost it to the casino, bro. And he really thought that, like, you know, what he decided to do next was gonna get us to be on his team somehow. So he's like, well, if you're not gonna help me, then you guys can't hang out with us anymore. And me and my friends, like, looked at each other and were like, okay, and just started walking out because we didn't care. I don't know this dude. I really could not care less how much money this guy has lost. It means literally nothing to me. I'm sorry, maybe, you know, that's a little bit rude, but if you go do a bunch of really dumb stuff that you're gonna have to explain to your wife why you're down 600 grand, hey, bro, that sucks for you. Good luck. But if I can't hang out with you anymore, so be it. Oh no, I'll go home and sleep fine at night. And so we start, like, walking out, and he kind of is following us, and we finally turn around, and he's, like, right behind us, and he's like, you know, I'm sorry, I was a little mad, you guys don't have to leave. And we're like, dude, you literally just accused us of being voodoo workers that were sent here to make you have bad luck so you would lose money to the casino, and now you're gonna sit here and be like, no, guys, come hang out, it was fun. So that was really weird to us. We all thought that was just, like, super weird. We didn't trust this dude at that point. We're like, we're gonna get robbed if we stay. So we decided to get out of there, and we walked outside the casino, honestly just laughing at the situation, because how could we not? Like, it's not every day you watch somebody lose 600 grand, accuse you of doing voodoo to make him lose it, and then, like, you know, him beg you to keep hanging out. After that situation, we decided it was probably best to head home anyways, so we ended up getting in it and, like, telling our Uber driver about it, and he thought it was hilarious. And to this day, it is still the biggest L I have ever seen anyone take ever. Losing that amount of money definitely counts up there as, like, one of the greatest L's you can take. Anyways, guys, I think that's gonna do it for the video, though. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, I would really appreciate you taking a second to press the like button and comment down below. It really just helps the video do better in the algorithm, and you know, the more people see this video, the more people get to enjoy it. So if you don't mind pressing the like button and commenting the word water bottle down below, I'd really appreciate it. Other than that, if y'all want more content, I do have a podcast called The Scuffed Cast. It's just with a couple of my friends, Dark Tom and Bumpkin. They're also YouTubers. We just talk about drama and all that stuff. The link will be down below, along with a link to the intro song if you feel like giving it a listen. The Spotify link's down there. And yeah, other than that, follow my socials. Instagram is just at Scrubby, Twitter at Scrubby_69, and the TikTok is at Scrubby Stories. Y'all could drop a follow on there. I post story times on that. So if that's something you're interested in, feel free. And yeah, on that note, guys, don't get anyone pregnant. If you do, make sure they're hot, and hopefully I will see you guys all next time with another video. I'm out. Peace.